let us now try to understand what are parabens. What is the history of parabens? Parabens are a set of chemicals which are extensively used as preservatives, especially in cosmetics. Now, they are being used in cosmetics for the prevention of molds, viruses, and different diseases. Parabens and their salts are used for fungicidal and bactericidal properties. Parabens are also used by the pharmaceutical industry, and they are now again appear as a food components in food industry as well. So parabens are, you can say that they are being used in cosmetic industries, pharmaceutical industries, and food industry as well. Parabens were discovered in shampoos, industrial moisturizers, shaving gels, cleaning gels, private lubricants, topical or parenteral prescribed drugs, and toothpaste. They are also used as meal additives. As I have told earlier, parabens are preservatives. They are being incorporated into the product to increase the shelf life. So being the preservation, they found their application in vast number of the cosmetic products, like cleaning products like shampoos, gels, other prescribed toothpaste. The substances which are used for the cleaning purpose have to add preservative for their prolonged period of the action. Now, the problem associated with the parabens are that, like other substances, they are also transdermally penetrate through the. As far as the chemistry of the parabens are concerned, parabens are basically derived from the para-hydroxybenzoic acid, which is found in many fruits and vegetables, for example, blueberries, carrots, and onions. This is the structure of the parabens. If you substitute the R group with the alkyl group such as methyl, it becomes a methyl paraben, ethyl group, ethyl paraben, propyl group, propyl paraben, or butyl group, butyl paraben. So these are the different types of the parabens: methyl paraben, ethyl paraben, propyl paraben, butyl paraben. They are being used into the industries for their preservation purpose. You can see the chemical structure of the parabens. Parabens have a long history of more than 100 years of their vast use into different categories of the product, of their different preservative action. Since they are bactericidal, they are vastly used in cosmetics. Parabens are used in various products, as I have told you earlier. They are also very well used in the food industry, for example, in mayonnaise, mustard, processed vegetables, frozen dairy products, jellies, soft drinks, etc. Now, we come to know about the main feature of the parabens. Now, let us discuss what are the side effects of the parabens. On one side, they are having very beneficial property. Now, let us explore what are the properties which are actually making it a controversial ingredient. The very first property is the allergic reaction. It was found that parabens are associated with the allergies. They are associated with the skin irritation. They are associated with the dermatitis, and may, when applied on the skin, they can cause rashes, blisters, and burning skin sensations. Parabens actually deeply penetrate into the skin via the transdermal permeation and disrupt the conventional functioning of the hormones. So the two properties which actually tarnish the image of parabens was allergic reaction on one side and activity. What happened is that parabens are linked with increased estrogen production. When they cause the increased estrogen production, what happens that the balance is being disturbed, resulting in an estrogen positive, sometimes carcinoma as well, and male physiological state problems. If there is an increased estrogen production, females are having a unique type of hormonal balance of estrogen and progesterone. When estrogen gets increased, this balance gets decreased. This balance is actually disturbed, and due to this disturbance, there may be a lot of issues that may also result into estrogen positive carcinomas. Now, if you have the more of the female hormone, the male hormone declines, and male physiological state problems occur when these substances are used in the cosmetic products. Now, because of this hormonal disbalance, it actually became the cause of breast cancer. It was in some research studies, it was found out that it was found into the accumulated, it was found to be accumulated over a period of time when used continuously inside the body system, resulting into breast carcinoma. So this linking actually got it a very bad image. Third side effect is the premature aging. The alkyl group kind of paraben is particularly damaging to the skin and will increase sensitivity to the sun. Applying paraben-containing product before going outdoors will cause your skin cells to die quicker than the normal ones exposed to the ultraviolet rays. So, skin care product should not be damaging to the skin. So, there came the trend of paraben-free products. Because of these harmful effects, because of these side effects, approach for the paraben-free products slowly developed over the time. So, you can understand the name being associated as controversial ingredient. I have told earlier, breast cancer, parabens are known to be xenoestrogen. Now, what is that? These are basically considered as endocrine disrupting chemicals, also known as the hormone mimicking chemicals, which means simply means that body can treat the paraben like a hormone. So if you are giving external hormone, then the hormonal imbalance will be disturbed. Now, when we talk about the cosmetics, we are only interested to beautify or clean or to have a good action over the skin. If any of the substance enters into the cosmetic formulation which is actually causing the inflammation, this is not desired property at all, and it should not be like that. So one should be very much concerned about the all the composition of the cosmetics. For example, parabens are found in the breast cancer cells, which represent that parabens may act like a... Now, as I've told, since it is linked up with the hormonal increased estrogen activity, it may also result into early puberty and decreased sperm count. The parabens are known as endocrine disruptors, as these are the substances that adversely have an effect on the endocrine system. Now, what is this? What this may cause? The system actually releases hormones into the blood and is concerned during a variety of functions associated with waste elimination, digestion, and metabolism. Endocrine disruptors like parabens will result in early adolescence. This is not desired. One is consuming cosmetics for beautification, for enhancing the skin properties, to have the glow. But incorporation of such type of the substance into the skin will result in such kind of hormonal imbalance. This is not acceptable at all. Parabens can even have an effect on the male genitals. So what should be the approach? What are the recommendations? Although having a history of 100 years, it is being recommended that one should not use parabens, because they are linked with the hormone imbalance problem. They are linked with the carcinomas. This is not at all acceptable. One should have an approach of being organic. Being organic means total preservative free. Although the product would not have the same shelf life as that of the preserved product, but cosmetic, this hormonal type of the problem is not at all acceptable with such kind of the cosmetics. So I hope I am clear and make you understand that why parabens are being graded as controversial ingredients, why their images were tarnished. Now, one interesting fact is that pharmaceutical companies are interested to add parabens into the cosmetic products. Why? Because parabens are easily available. They are very cheap substances to be incorporated. Moreover, they are strengthening the shelf life. They are strengthening the integrity of the product. So one, for the purpose of the sale, companies will never tell you the effects which are associated with the parabens, like inflammation, dermatitis, skin problems, early adolescence, hormonal imbalance, increased estrogen activity, which would further result in the decreased male hormonal system. This is not acceptable. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please do like, share, and subscribe if you like my video. Please also share your views on the comment box. Thank you so much.